Dear people of God, our Heavenly Father sent his Son into the world, not to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved, that all who believe in him might be delivered from the power of sin and death and become heirs with him of everlasting life. We pray, therefore, for people everywhere, according to their needs.
Let us pray for the Jewish people who possess an eternal covenant with the Lord, who delivered them from bondage to freedom, for continued faithfulness to God's covenant with them, for their flourishing in peace as witnesses to God's sustaining love, for safety from all malice and harm, for the fullness of redemption, for the sake of God's name. The unity and concord may exist between Israel and the Church, Jews and Gentiles, in obedience to God's will. God of Abraham, you planted your people Israel as the root and grafted us as wild branches into a single olive tree of praise to you. As we come near to the cross, we lament the history of prejudice and violence we have fomented between ourselves and your faithful people of whom Jesus was born. Bless the children of your covenant, Jew and Gentile alike, as we strive together to attain the fullness of your blessing for the world. Amen.
Let us pray for the Church Universal, the body of Christ throughout the world, for its unity in witness and service, for all bishops and other ministers and the people whom they serve, for all Christians in this community, for those about to be baptized, that God will conform the Church in faith, increase it in love, and preserve it in peace. Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers which we offer before you for all members of your holy Church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us pray for those who have not embraced God's redemptive love, for those who are distant from God, for those who have lost their faith, for those without faith, for those hardened by sin and indifference, for the contemptuous and the scornful, for those who have been wounded by the people of Christ, for those who have persecuted others in the name of Christ, for those who are persecutors of his disciples, that God will lead sinners to repentance and sustain all in a life of faith and obedience. Merciful God, the source of life and fountain of mercy, let the gospel of your Son, Jesus Christ, be preached with grace and love. Turn the hearts of the followers of Jesus who have harmed others in his name. Lead all to repentance and amendment of life, and sustain by your loving grace all who lift their eyes to you. Amen.
Let us pray for all the nations and people of the earth, and for those in authority among them. For Justin Trudeau, Prime Minister of Canada, Doug Ford, Premier of Ontario. For all those who serve the common good, that by God's grace they may seek justice and truth, and live in peace and concord. Almighty God, kindle, we pray, in every heart the true love of peace, and guide with your wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that in tranquility your dominion may increase, until the earth is filled with the knowledge of your love, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray for all who suffer and are afflicted in body or in mind, for those who are hungry and homeless, destitute and oppressed, for those who are ill or disabled in body, mind, or spirit, for those in loneliness, fear, and anguish, for those who face temptation, doubt, or despair. For those who are sorrowful and bereaved, for those who are persecuted for the sake of Christ, for prisoners, refugees, and captives, for victims of war, genocide, and trafficking, and all those in mortal danger, that God in his mercy will comfort and relieve them and grant them the knowledge of his love and stir up in us the will and patience to minister to their needs. Gracious God, the comfort of all who sorrow, the strength of all who suffer, let the cry of those in misery and need come to you, that they may find your mercy present with them in all their afflictions. And give us, we pray, the strength to serve them for the sake of him who suffered for us, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Let us commit ourselves to God and pray for the grace of a holy life, that with all who have departed this world and have died in the peace of Christ, those whose faith is known to God alone, we may be accounted worthy to enter into the fullness of the joy of our Lord, receive the crown of life in the day of resurrection. O God of unchangeable power and eternal light, look favorably on your whole church, that wonderful and sacred mystery, by the effectual working of your providence. Carry out in tranquility the plan of salvation, that the whole world see and know that things which were cast down are being raised up, and things which had grown old are being made new, and that all things are being brought to their perfection by him through whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
We join our hearts and minds together now in the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, we pray you to set your passion, cross, and death between your judgment and our souls now and in the hour of our death. Give mercy and grace to the living, pardon and rest to the dead. To your holy church, peace and concord, and to us sinners, everlasting life and glory. For with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, now and forever. Amen.